Whether your home is massive or minuscule, not to scale, moving can be hard work.
Sure can. In fact, many of you say moving house is more stressful than getting divorced or losing your job.
Imagine if you got divorced, lost your job and moved your house all on the same day. What a day you'd be having. It can be super traumatic, so the last thing you want is a moving company who makes changing homes even tougher.
That's right. Here's Jill.
You're moving to a new home. Exciting! You've just got to pack up your whole life and shift it.
I hate it.
Okay, not so exciting.
I think that it's probably one of the most stressful things that a person can have to do.
Jenny Hill knows about stress. Her job's helping people get through drug and alcohol addiction. Plus,
I'm a solo parent, so it's not like I have a house full of people to help me move.
So when moving from one Auckland suburb to another, she wanted to share the load.
I got a bunch of quotes.
She chose a removal company called Easy Move.
They started off okay. They were really friendly.
Most of her stuff got moved in, but then...
And then they said they had to leave, so I rang their boss and he said, oh, no, they can't stay anyway. They've got another job on. They have to go. I'll get them to move all the heavy things.
And so, Jenny says, they left.
I cried. I cried because I didn't know what to do.
There were still boxes at her old house, some left at the top of her driveway. Thankfully...
The chorus guy was here putting the fibre and he helped. The lady from next door helped.
She also posted a cry for help on Facebook.
And then some other friends came and helped move stuff from the other place as well.
Time to sort her stuff and unpack her thoughts.
I felt pretty broken and really exhausted. So I wrote a review on the moving company and what I felt wasn't a good job.
It was a Google review.
That's my right to be able to have an opinion and to be able to share that, because otherwise how are other people going to know?
And she signed off with...
Avoid at all costs.
But then...
Got a text from the owner, the boss of the moving company, saying that he was going to bill me for the extra time his guys spent moving my stuff. He would remove the bill if I removed the Google review. I thought, he's threatening me.
Easy Move manager Glenn Owens sees things differently.
Yeah, no, that's absolute load of rubbish. It wasn't left at the top of the driveway. The guys took all the big stuff into the property, got the job done, and I actually wasn't going to charge her for the extra work. And so she goes off and goes and puts the big, huge, bad rating online.
Yes, but if you completed the job and she was happy, then surely she wouldn't have left a bad rating.
Well, you get customers like that, I'm afraid.
Jenny's response when we told her...
Oh, what? Are you serious? That's the most ridiculous thing.
She left the review up and...
Called MBIE and they said that there's been a number of breaches around my rights as a consumer.
Jenny now knows an early warning sign was that Easy Move didn't visit her house pre-move or even ask for photos.
So I filled in an online quote which asks like how many boxes you have and all the furniture that you have and where you're going and what the access is like to the property.
Based on this, she was quoted a 2.5 hour job plus half hour drive time.
If they quote an amount of time, they should be able to carry out the work in that time. They're the experts.
Raymond Dobby agrees he used to be in the removals business, running World Removals for over 20 years.
No way you can do it with an online form.
He says jobs should never be left unfinished and it's vital to do thorough assessments.
You have to really ask lots of questions of the client, go and see the place.
Glenn's response, the fact it was a WINS payment, which means...
No time for me to go drive out there and have a look at things because they're already in the office. Pretty much getting ready to pay them straight away.
Jenny says she got a WINS loan to pay and there was over a week between quote and payment. Back to you, Glenn.
The thing is, like we usually have more than one job a day. We usually have maybe two or three.
He then blamed Jenny's property.
Well, that it was actually up a dirt track hill.
But Jenny had written about access in her online form.
I was honest about the fact there is no driveway access to the property and that there's like a little path that goes through the trees.
Raymond Dobby believes it's far too easy for companies to cut corners.
People can do anything they like. There's no industry standards in what we do at all.
He says you can't beat face-to-face contact and people should be cautious trusting just a website.
Websites are now the face of a shop. They are as much money or as clever as that website developer is.
As for reviews, well, they don't always tell the full story.
I would get a call every second day for someone who wanted to offer me something. And some of them were, we can get you as many reviews as you like.
Raymond's advice?
Talk to your friends. Go out onto maybe your community Facebook page and get recommendations.
Great for Jenny's next move, but she's still facing that extra work bill for this one.
I'm getting reminder notices to pay the $198. Personally, I feel a bit scared that the amount's going to get sent to debt collection.
Fortunately, after we get involved, Glenn sees sense.
I'm really happy to drop the invoices.
Feels really good. Yeah. It's a big weight off my shoulders, so.
For Jenny, the best result, though, is her review is still online.
I think leaving a review is really important. I think it's really important to speak up and, you know, let other people know if it's been really bad or really good as well, you know.
That is very good advice because we are more likely to leave a bad review than a good review, and you need the good reviews there too.
Yeah, especially if you've watched your favourite TV show and want to leave a positive review about the presenters.